rotten thing.
Look, I think I will go and have a word with her. Now, you stay here, okay?
Oh, you're right, eh, Mr. Bridges.
Good.
Oh!
What's the matter, Lizzie? Oh. What's the matter? Shh, what's the matter?
Oh, my buddy. Buddy, Mr. Bridges. Oh.
Wrong, oh. Lizzie. Shh. There are two bodies. You can be free too. See?
Oh, Jesus.
I think she's had a heart attack, Cass. You better go and get help.
Oh, Brock.
Quickly, Parker.
Yeah.
Bye, Lizzie. You're free now.
Lizzie? Oh, hang on. Coming.
I'm going to need you in a minute.
What for?
You're going to start a punch-up. Something to keep the screws occupied.
What are you going to be doing?
Don't ask questions.
I'm entitled
to... You're entitled to nothing. But you won't like what you get if you don't do as I tell you.
Okay. Only asking. You'll give me the nod?
Yeah. Just keep your eyes open. Well, go on, get going.
Those news crews up there.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they scout around if I see a story.
They won't get much here, will they?
No, I don't suppose they will.
Okay, Brian, hand them over.
I almost feel like giving them away.
Why don't you? I'll make their day.
I want my smoke now!
He's only going to need it to you.
Hey, I'm a helicopter. What's going on?
To us.
And Uncle Archie.
Let's not forget the horse either.
You all right, Mom?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just have to go to the loo, that's all.
Hey, Uncle Arch. Uncle Arch. Congratulations, Uncle Arch.
Thanks, Jeff. Hello, Laurie.
Oh, hello, Uncle Arch. This is my mother.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you, Mrs.
Judy. Everyone calls me Judy.
It's okay by me, Judy. Well, what are we all drinking?
Well, nothing at the moment, thanks, Uncle Arch. Mum and I have to go.
Go? Already?
We'll be back in a second.
Oh, yeah, I see what you mean. Well, I'll have the champers lined up when you get back.
Harry, you remember the day...
Arch Maynard.
Hello, Mr. Maynard. My name's Andrew McLeod. I'm a friend of Jeff's from up north.
Oh, yeah?
Look, I've been in New Zealand a couple of years. I heard he was stopping with you. Is that right?
Well, no. He's in town on his honeymoon.
Oh, so he did marry her.
Oh, you know Laurie?
Well, not really, but he wrote to me about her.
Oh, is that a fact?
Yeah.
The number of letters we got, I thought he was illiterate.
Well, actually, it was the only one I ever got myself, I can assure you. Look, I wonder if you could help me contact him. I didn't want to bust in his honeymoon, but I've only got a couple of days left before I go back to New Zealand.
Oh, I can't see any harm in that. They're staying with Laurie's mum.
Hang on a minute, I'll get you the address.
Good.
G'day.
Small world, isn't it, Lizzie?
Get out of this car before I scream my lungs out.
Oh, I don't think I do that, Lizzie. I mean, I'm not causing any harm. Just a passenger. Just want a bit of your time, that's all. You can even start the meter going if you want.
Just say what you have to say and get out.
It's good thinking, Brian. Just hear me out, there'll be no trouble. You see, I've been having a pretty hard time since the Commander Pendridge. Very difficult making ends meet.
It's your fault, isn't it?
I don't see it that way, Lizzie. I think it's your fault. Seeing how it is, I'm going to give you a chance just to make amends.
Really? You can't get blood out of a stone, can you?
Don't treat me like a fool, Brian. I don't like it. I might just lose my temper. You've got a daughter, haven't you? She just married a nice, upright young man. His uncle just happens to be a pretty well-heeled man of property. And we're coming through.
Why do you have to drag Arch and Jeff into this?
The reason why I want to drag them in is that I need a wee loan, say about $5,000, just to get me started off afresh. I think you can convince Uncle Arch to help you out there, don't you?
You get out of this car before I call the cops. You think I was born yesterday? $5,000 would only just be a down payment.
You're smart, right? You always were. That's how I know you'll get that money for me. Otherwise, I'll tell that wee daughter of yours and her husband. Her mother used to work for me in the massage parlor. Turning tricks at $20 a throw. Lying flat in your back.
She'd never believe you, you bastard.
Why shouldn't she? It's the truth. They can check up with the police files. It's all there. Well, not all. There's a few nasty details that they don't even know about. But I remember them. Plus a few more stories. It would really make that wee girl of yours here curl.
You don't care who you hurt, do you?
Care about me first, Brian. That's the law of the jungle. Still, you're right. Your daughter doesn't have to know that her mother was a prostitute. That's for you to decide. You just think it over, Lassie. I'll be in touch real soon. Company, seeing as how your daughter's gone away now.
Well, they've gone to the movies, haven't they? I'll be back any minute.
Is that a fact? Funny they took all the luggage with them, didn't they? Eh? I'd say they'd gone to Archie's for a couple of days, wouldn't you? See, I know Archie quite well. Had a long chat with him on the phone just the other day.
It's about that Jock Stewart who used to work here. He's turned up again and he's demanding money from her and getting heavy and everything.
What's he doing? Blackmailing her? Threats of violence? Took a lot of courage.
strange for Doreen to speak to me, especially with the way the women are treating her at the moment.
Are you planning on bringing in the police?
I think it's the best way, don't you?
I don't. I don't want them involved in this.
Look, I could report it myself.
I'll deny it.
Judy, why don't you tell me the whole story? And then perhaps you'll be interested in an idea that I've got.
You must think I'm a real fool, Brian. You know how long it took me to find out your address that day after the trust, don't you? Wouldn't take me more than about, 10 minutes to find out her address in Queensland. Might even be worth the trip up there. She's quite a spunky-looking little lady.
You bastard!
Did I get that money? I'll do a pay visit to that wee daughter of yours.
Hey? Hi there, Mrs. Stewart.
What's this? Hidden witnesses? You're getting devious, Brian. Very devious.
I suggest you leave this place now and never come back. The police will be very interested in what I just overheard.
You must be a very brave woman, Mrs. Morris. Because I know you're not a fool. I could get rid of the two of you right here and now. No one would be any the wiser.
You don't think I'd be stupid enough not to let anyone know where I am or who I'm with? Police will pick you up in a couple of hours.
You're bluffing.
Pentridge must have been a breeze for you last time. Locked in isolation, away from all the other prisoners who hated you. I wonder what sort of treatment you'll get next time when they find out you've killed a fellow prison officer. I think you've seen the last of him.
I hope so.
If you want to make certain, we'll call the police.
No. Laurie and Jeff, I don't want them going through all this. Lots of her friends in Queensland know I'm her mother. I don't want it to hit the newspapers.
Mrs. Morris?
Oh, my God! Go away! Go away! Ah, go away!
You can't beat this too. You're going to stop me, do you?
And I suppose you're wondering what I'm going to do to you, Brian. Well, I'm going to hurt you. I'm going to hurt you real bad. Just to teach you a lesson. Of course, now that Meg Morris has stuck her nose in, I have to shoot through after I've done it. Because she'll inform the police as soon as she finds out where you are. I think Queensland might be a nice place to go to. It's nice at this time of the year. Plenty of sunshine, lots of women. I might even look up little Laurie for you, eh? You'd appreciate that. Well, you're recovering in the hospital, wouldn't you, eh? Getting a letter from Laurie saying how she'd run into your old friend, Jock Stewart.
You evil bastard! You'll never hurt Laurie, you evil bastard! I'll kill you, son of a bitch! I'll never do that!
You make too many bloody mistakes!
God's sake. For God's sake, Bride, please help me.
Please, I can't move.
Sharon couldn't move either. You remember Sharon, Jock? Because I do. Well, this one's for Sharon. And Dor. And me. And all the women that you've bashed and hurt.
Please. At least call an ambulance. Please, I can't move. Oh, please, I can't move. Oh, please, please. Oh, please, Brian.
Her name is Rita Connors.
Yeah, that's right. Rita the Beater.
And you have been charged with assault occasioning grievous bodily harm and are to be held on remand until the time set for your trial. Is that correct?
Sounded good to me. I suspicious.
Yes or no?
Yeah. Sure.
Right, Connors, empty your pockets on the counter. Hurry up.
Anything you say, Governor.
Miss Ferguson, and I do not appreciate people who waste my time.
One new snot rag, $1.20 in small change, one a slash of socks. He left her behind one night, silly bugger.
Get on with it.
A couple of chain links for me, Harley. Won't be needing them in here, eh?
Come on, get on with it. The belt too. Is that all?
Not unless you want to try scraping me tats off.
Listen, one more remark out of turn from you and you will spend your first 24 hours in here in solitary, understood?
There's nothing wrong with a bit of a laugh, is there, Miss Ferguson?
Everything all right?
Nothing I can't handle. I'll have the jacket now.
Oh. Sorry, comes with the furniture.
Not with those chains, it doesn't. Hand over the jacket.
Hang on, I'm on remand. I thought that meant I was supposed to keep my own clothes.
Other prisoners could get hold of that jacket and use the chains as weapons.
Any
now, don't
so
waste
much
any...
as touches it, they won't know what hit them. I probably couldn't stand the pong anyway.
Come on, I haven't got all day. Hand it over.
I'm trying to tell you. The chains ain't no weapon. It goes with me and me bike.
Either you give us the jacket or we take it off you forcibly. Now, what's it to be?
I think I can solve this.
Hey, what do you think to...
Now, you can wear the filthy rag as often as you like.
You shouldn't have done that.
You wouldn't be threatening me, would you, Connors?
Now, why would I threaten a nice person like you?
We won't tolerate insolence. Remember that, will you?
Sign that. Now, get over there. There you are, Connors. Get used to it. You're going to be here for quite a while.
I haven't been tried yet, remember?
Oh, I don't think there's much doubt about that, is there? Unless the courts have changed their minds about bikies who go around bashing up innocent people.
It served her right. No one stuffs the conquerors around and gets away with it.
Oh, the conquerors. Real little rat pack, aren't you? Well, you're on your own now. Haven't got your mates in here to help you when you get into trouble.
All for one and one for all. Don't worry, I can handle myself.
Here's the rules. Read them and make sure you stick to them.
Yeah, I've been inside before, you know.
I don't like troublemakers, Connors. You push me and I'll come down on you like a ton of bricks.
That's so.
Yeah, because I can recognize scum when I see it. And right now, I'm staring it in the face.
That's funny. So am I. Real snappy little uniform you got there, Miss Ferguson. Which reminds me. I still owe you for pulling the stripes off mine.
It wasn't too clever. I could have you thrown in the pound for assaulting an officer.
Without a mark on you? You'll know when you're being assaulted.
Get your bed made and your things put away. I'll be back in 10 minutes to check.
Miss Ferguson, what's the chances of me working in with the girls? I'm not the shy, retiring type, if you know what I mean.
Wouldn't have thought you were the working type either.
Like a bit of company. Are you going to ask the governor or am I going to have to do it myself? Hey, where do you think you're going?
Sorry, I thought you were busy.
No, just riding me Harley. Well, sort of, in me mind. Fantasizing, you know what I mean?
Yeah. What's a Harley?
It's my bike. Harley. Harley Davidson, you know? Never even dirtied your bum on the back of one, have you? What's your name, anyway?
Eve. Eve Wilder.
Rita. Rita the Beater, they call me. Grab a pew. Going mad cooped up in here by myself.
Oh, thanks anyway.
I'm not going to bite your head off. It's too pretty for that. You're a real model type, aren't you?
I really do have
to. Oh, you don't have to worry about me, darling. I'm into blokes in a big way. That's what's going to kill me about this place. No bike and no blokes. I mean, it's bloody criminal. How's a red-blooded Aussie Sheila supposed to go 5 years without a fella, eh?
But you're only on remand, aren't you?
Yeah, can we try? I've got a hope of getting off, though.
What did you do?
First time, all right? You don't know the rules about asking someone what they've done.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to pry.
Hell, I never believed in any of that crap anyway. Better to be up front, I always reckon. I beat up a chick who I caught sleeping with my fella. My ex-fella, Slasher. I mean, I wouldn't have minded except the bitch was hanging around with the bloody screamers. Oh, jeez. One minute he's out rumbling against the buggers, the next minute he's got one of their moles in the cot with him. I mean, you can't have it both ways. You're either a conqueror or you're not.
Is this your club, the Conquerors?
Yeah, too right.
I'd like you to meet Rita Connors. She's on remand, but she's volunteered for work duties. I'll leave the introductions to you, Flynn.
Well, don't mind if I do. Connors, eh? Name's Lou Kelly. Fair enough. Well, you going to introduce me around or not?
Hey, my name's Alice.
Yeah, we call her Lurch after that show on the telly.
I'm Julie Egbert.
G'day, Julie. Lurch, eh? You must be Flynn.
Nora.
Top dog?
Yeah, that's right. That's Reb Keane. See Patterson.
Hi. Where'd you get the jacket? Which bike are you nicked off?
Looking at the owner right here.
Yeah, you a bikey, eh?
Was till they threw me in here. Not having me bike's like having me right arm cut off.
See, I told ya.
Must be a few horses power in this thing. How about I start working here? You know, sometimes it helps just to talk about it.
No, I don't want to.
Yeah, I know. I heard Ferguson smashed up all your little mates. She likes to make people bloody miserable, doesn't she?
Yeah. Who are you?
Rita. Rita Connors. I just came in to Savo. You were in the print shop or something.
Yeah? Oh, I thought I didn't know you.
Yeah, well, we fixed that up, haven't we?
Yeah, I guess so.
Look at these little fellas, will you? I reckon they don't know what happened. Did you faint when the freak came in?
Oh, see, they'd be real scared, but... See, that's Ivy, and she used to stand next to Phil, but now Phil's dead.
But Ivy's not dead. Neither's this one. What's her name?
Oh, that one. That one's called Willie. I called her after a mate of mine who escaped. Do you think this one's really going to be okay?
Well, I reckon you're going to have to nurse her and the others. After all, they've had a terrible shock.
Oh, I can nurse them. I'm real good at it.
Yeah, I'll bet you are. Don't worry. They'll make it. That's funny. I could have sworn this was my cell.
Yeah, well, since you're so big on manners, we've come to teach you some.
I don't think there's a single thing you could teach me, Kelly.
You reckon? Well, we're going to teach you how to treat a top dog for starters.
I don't care what you call yourself. You stay out of my way. You mess with me again and I swear it'll be the last thing you ever do. Got it?
If we're going to fix Smith, I want to make bloody sure she stays fixed. I mean, what are we going to tell the screws if she ends up looking like a piece of raw meat?
Oh, believe me, she won't have a mark on her. Not physically. When we're through with Smith, she's going to spend the rest of her life in hospital. You see, I've found a chink in her armour. Trust me.
Trust you? You're out of your head.
Oh, not me, Mackenzie. But you're on the right track. Now, are you with me or not?
Why not? I've got nothing to lose, have I?
How right you are.
The spirit's really desperate. It's very unhappy.
Yeah, well, things couldn't be any worse there than they are here.
Please, Bea, you mustn't mock the spirit world. It's you the spirit wants.
Yeah? Well, it's on my checks in the mail.
Oh, why won't you listen? I've got a name to give you. It says to tell you... Debbie.
Listen to me. You can play silly buggers with the rest of them if you want to. But don't you start playing dangerous games with me, because I won't stand for it.
Well, I don't understand. What have I said to upset her?
Debbie. That was Bea's daughter.
Oh, my God.
I reckon Debbie is trying to talk to you.
I remember my old dog Clive. His ear fell off when I was going to hospital to have my appendix out. Oh, I wouldn't go until he'd sewn his ear back on. Mum. Mum, I've been trying to reach you for so long.
Debbie?
Oh, I had to tell you, Mum. I didn't ID. I'd never do that. They held me down. Oh, God. I couldn't get away. They pumped the heroin into my arm.
Go on. What else? Who's they?
What?
You've got to tell me more. Who's they?
I don't know. I don't even know what the message means. All I know is that's all there is.
You've got to. This is my kid. I couldn't know.
Well, it's not my fault, Bea. All I am is the medium.
Oh, God, Debbie.
I'm sorry, Bea. Really sorry. I think I better go and lie down.
Kerry Jacobs?
That's right.
I'm Joan Ferguson. We spoke on the phone about Bea Smith.
Oh, Debbie Smith's mother. Mm-hmm. Come in, weren't you?
Thank you.
I'll get the letters for you. Go in. I really had to think after our talk. Thought I may have thrown all these out after my husband died. Letters can be cruel after something like that.
Oh, yes, I can imagine that.
Look, I'm sorry, but I really want to be sure I'm doing the right thing. Debbie really was my very best friend, and I'd hate to do anything to hurt her mother. Well, Mrs. Smith was a nice lady, despite what the papers said.
Oh, she still is. That's why I'm trying to help her.
I just don't see how Debbie's letters could help after all these years. I mean, how could they be used in a parole hearing?
Well, you see, if the letters can prove that Debbie and her mother were close, then the board can be reminded that the crime was a crime of passion, and I don't think a mother should be punished for that. Do you?
No. Debbie wrote that just before she died.
This. We're going to use part of a letter that her daughter wrote. A very special part. Hey, one more night of softening up and I think we'll let her daughter give it to her.
Pity you're wearing that uniform. I could almost grow to like you.
you want?
Well, I know you probably would have told me, but have there been any more messages from Debbie?
No. No, Debbie's back in the spirit world. Look, she delivered a message and she's gone. It's all finished now. You must accept that.
No, it isn't. I know it isn't. She tried to reach me last night.
Look, it's up to you now. I mean, Debbie doesn't need me anymore. She just needs a mother.
Mom.
Mom. Mom, I'm so lonely.
Debbie.
Help me, Mom.
Debbie, no. I can't.
Didn't eat a thing yesterday. And what with all that screaming the other night, oh, God.
I wish we could talk together the way we used to. I feel so alone now. Can't you come to see me? I really need you. Come soon, love, Debbie.
From Debbie saying she needs me.
Oh. Debbie's dead, love. She went a long time ago.
No, there's a letter.
I mean, if you push just a little harder, I'm sure that you might find that Smith is suicidal. That is, if you're interested.
Hey, I'm interested.
What are you doing to yourself? Come on, you gotta eat. Oh, B, you can't let yourself go like this, love.
Doesn't matter anymore.
What doesn't?
Anything.
Don't talk such rubbish. Come on.
Not after tonight.
Aye.
We'll be together again.
Of course we will.
I wasn't there last time she needed me. This time it'll be different. She's my daughter. And she needs me.
I take it contact was made.
Well and truly. You took your time about it, though.
Oh, for God's sake, why don't you leave me alone? I did what you bloody wanted.
Highly strung, these supernatural types.
Please, Mom, I need you.
Debbie.
Help you, but I don't know how. Debbie.
Mom. She looks dreadful.
She's alive. That's all that matters.
Mm. I heard the doctor say she'd made an incredible recovery. She's an amazing old lady.
You're no spring chicken yourself, Min Donovan, so watch your language.
You old faker, you. We thought you were asleep.
How are you feeling, dear?
Not bad. Feel a lot better if they'd change channels, though. Gets very boring watching your old ticker bouncing up and down on that thing.
Well, you just be grateful it's still bouncing, huh?
No, we're awfully worried about you, Lizzie, but, well, I feel much better now that I've seen you.
I thought you said that I look dreadful.
Well, anyone would with all those tubes and things. You're not going to blow a fuse, are you?
Hey, where's Cassa? Why didn't she come see me?
They'd only let three of us in. She'll be coming.
She's all right, isn't she? Bridges didn't hurt her, did he?
No, she's fine. She's just a bit upset, that's all.
Excuse me, ladies. I think we better do as the doctor said, don't you? One at a time?
Oh, yeah. We won't make any...
Come on, fix them. That's it, right. We'll be back in a minute.
Then. Yes, we'll see you soon.
They're pretty?
Huh? Mm.
You scared the hell out of me, you know that? I thought you were a goner this time.
I thought I was myself, Jude. But you know something? I didn't care.
Oh, come on.
No, it's true, love. I don't know what happened, but I suddenly felt safe. I felt free. And you know who I saw? All our old mates. Mum, Patty, Mouse, and Hayes. They were all there. And I talked to them. And then who do you reckon came along? Maxie. Little bugger. What the bloody hell are you doing here? She said. And when I told her what happened, she told me to bugger off and get back and look after you lot. Oh, don't be upset, love. I'm not. You want to know why? Because she's happy. They're all really booing.
Did you manage to dump it?
Oh, God, thank God.
Thank goodness Mrs. Barry didn't see my hands. They're shaking like leaves.
Well, you've got rid of the only evidence there is. Now they can't convict
me. Eve, I could never have done anything else. You know that. I'd better go. Mrs. Barry will get suspicious if we stay too long.
David, believe in what you're doing. Believe in us.
I do. Very much.
David, wait!
What is it?
You're finished, I see.
I think so. Was there something else, Miss Wilde?
Nothing. You can wait.
I'll be back for you as soon as I've seen Mr. Adams out.
Wilder, back to your cell.
I think we need to talk.
There's nothing to talk about. Your interview's over. I'm taking you back to your cell.
Oh, come on. You must have heard something.
Well, it's quite clear that you're guilty, if that's what you mean, and that your solicitor is an accomplice.
What's happened to him?
The governor will decide on appropriate action against both of you the minute I make my report. You can be sure of that.
You mean you haven't spoken to her yet?
Oh, no, but I will. The minute she returns. And let's get a move on.
You're a bit slow, aren't you, Keen?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Morris. Can't seem to get my mind into gear after that session with Dr. Weiss.
Well, on with your work.
He didn't say anything, did he, when he was leaving?
If and when he says anything, you should probably talk. Now, I'll be back as well.
Keen, I think you can expect to hear some good news.
Thanks. Said she'd be back for me once she'd taken Mr. Adams to reception. I heard her lock the door and that's the last I saw of her.
Did you hear any sounds outside the door when she was due back? The sound of a scuffle or an argument, anything at all?
No, I'd... Where There was something now you mention it. It sounded like a voice.
Who?
Well, I can't be sure, but it sounded like... I want to tell you, Mrs. Reynolds, for Mrs. Barry's sake, but I can't. It'd be lagging.
An officer has been very badly injured. She may even die. Now, if you heard something, I want to know about it.
I did hear a voice. It sounded like Reb Keane's. I only heard it because their voices were raised. They must have been quarreling or something.
See.
When Mrs. Barry didn't come back, I started to panic. I couldn't bear being in that small room, and that's when Mrs. Slattery came and told me what had happened. I don't understand. Reb was so sure she was going to get out.
Yes. Thanks, Pat. The ambulance has just left.
How could anyone do that to her? She wouldn't hurt a soul.
You want to blow it for everybody?
Well, it's just that I feel real bad about leaving Lizzie back there, and this place is really giving me the creeps.
And you listen to me. You ought to blow it for everyone if you do that. You should have thought of all of that before, and if you're not coming with us, you can stay right here, and you can stay here until we get away. And that's a long way away. Now, what's it going to be?
Oh, okay, I'm coming.
I think so. Which way is it, Mas?
Down here.
Come on, let's get out of here.
God, it's better out there, all them kids, bless them.
She's gone, you know.
Huh?
Doreen, she's gone. You'll never see her again.
How the hell did she get in here?
This way, Lizzie! What are you doing here, Lizzie?
I brought Teddy. I'm coming with you. Yeah, well, fat lot of good that's gonna do you. Dressed like that, the cops will be onto us in a flash.
Oh, I didn't think of that. I didn't want Dora to go out by herself. Well, we could think of something, couldn't we, Duke? You know, hide her in the back of the truck, you know?
God, look, I don't have time to think about that now. Let's just get going, eh?
Oh, come on, Lizzie.
We drag the cover back on and then get the hell out of here. I don't want to attract any attention.
How will you get out?
I'll be able to lift this from inside, don't you worry. And then tell Margot to cover for me and Lizzie until I get back. I'll be back as soon as I can. Come on.
Mm-hmm.
Leslie, you did tell her you were coming here, didn't you?
Well, there wasn't time, really.
Oh, Lizzie. Bea! Hey, Bea!
Yeah?
Down here, love. Watch, it's slippery there. That's right. Oh, it's a bit here.
Where is she?
Round the corner.
Lizzie, what do you think you're playing at?
I'm sorry, Bea. I didn't want Dora to go off by herself.
You silly old bugger. How long do you think she'd last with you hanging on? The cops will pick you up in 10 seconds flat. And bang will go your chances of ever being outside with your family.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
Come on, she's coming back with me. Come on, get going, you lot.
Thanks a lot, love. Look after yourselves.
Lizzie!
I'll be all right, honest.
Oh, God, you will.
Oh, come on, you two!
Bye, Doreen.
Bye.
Good luck, love.
Come on, Dor.
Think you're doing? Why aren't you inside?
It's a funeral.
What?
Now, poor soul, she's dead and gone.
And she got what she deserved. She murdered my Megan and now I've buried her.
That's enough of that.
What's dead is dead.
We'll have to do better than that to convince a jury. You're no more crazy than the rest of them. Now get a move on. Hey, guard! Wake up! You're supposed to make sure no one leaves the marquee. I've just found this woman wandering around out here. You're a security guard, behave like one. No one's allowed to go anywhere near the fence.
Lucky heaven, Larry.
Oh, when we ever live. Bloody escapes, they never work.
What are we gonna do?
Dory's not going anywhere in that leg. I'm going back to get someone to help.
Yeah, maybe Margot can help us get Dora out.
Oh, come on, with the lesbian army of screws all over the garden.
Oh, I didn't think of that.
We're going to have to tell the screws.
Oh. Yeah, I'm fitting a tips to the rescue.
I'm going back now. I'll wait at the bottom of the ladder to give Judy a mouse and a chance to get away. At least someone will have got themselves out of here. I'm going to take the torch with me.
Do you think you'd be able to find the opening?
No, well, I'll find her. I won't be long. Just back up. Chin up. Oh. At least we're not all buried under that lot.
What a mess. Lucky I came down with that. Well, if I hadn't come down, you would have been left here in the dark all on your own. Yeah. Maybe you are the fairy godmother after all, Lizzie.
Have a look at you. You look shocking, love. Right, okay, make that smooth. How do I look, huh?
You wouldn't make the front cover of Vogue. There's dirt in your hair. I'll get it out. Shoulders.
All right. Thank you very much. That's a big chance, huh? Mouse out of a drain pipe, right? Oh. Come on, just take a look.
Right.
Me too. We'll take care of each other.
You know, Kevin won't need a divorce now, because he'll be a widower.
Poor young Kev. He was a nice young man. He loved you, though. I know that.
Yeah, I loved him too. Do you reckon they'll come to our funeral?
Who?
Mrs. Davidson and them.
Oh, she'll come. So will Mrs. J. But old vinegar tits, she won't. Oh, no, she wouldn't.
She might.
Oh, for Christ's sake, what do you do, Charlotte? We're not going to die in this stinking drain. We are not going to die. We're going to get out of here. We're going to get out. I'm not going to let you die here. I'm going to get you out. I'm going to get you out. We're not going to die. We're not going to die.
The speed limit is 90 kilometres per hour. Didn't you see any signs?
No, I didn't. I was in a bit of a state, you know. Tired. I've been travelling a long time.
Why didn't you stop?
I guess I panicked.
Let's see your licence. Sandra Bates.
Yeah. Hey, I know you. You're on the Wentworth 6.
All right, Trip. If you'll tell us where this manhole is, I won't be so hard on you.
You might as well. The others will be well away by now.
Okay, but only because Irene ought to have a proper funeral and nothing else.
Good girl.
Thank you, Mr. Fletcher. Would you organize the search? I'll advise the police.
Come on, Trip.
What do you mean you're not sure?
Well, it didn't look like this the last time I saw it. It's been covered up.
You don't know who did it?
No, sir.
All right. Come on, let's get into it.
Remember when you first came to Wentworth Door? You weren't even 17. Just a little whippersnapper. They said they couldn't look after you in the girls' home. So they sent you to prison before your time. I knew you wasn't tough. All you needed was someone to love you. Don't leave me now, don't.
No, no, no.
Billy. Billy, it's Doris. Just that. Billy, Billy.
God, Lizzie's still down here.
Don't let her die. Don't let her die. Oh, thank God. Thank God.
She's still alive. Take care of Lizzie, will you? Anything broken? Oh, that doesn't look like it.
Oh, fine, baby. You can't leave her there.
Where is she, Lizzie? I'll go look for her. So, you stay with me and show me the way back.
Don't leave me down here.
Another dead end. Birdsworth must have been hallucinating. Let's go back.
Listen.
Where's it coming from?
Hello, Patty.
What the hell are you doing? You scared the living daylights out of me.
I've been waiting for you.
You didn't know I was coming here.
Well, I knew somebody had lobbed sooner or later. Being you is just a bonus for me.
What do you want?
An excuse to stay in Wentworth.
Well, you're a bit late. Hazel's out.
Like I said, you'll do.
Back off or I'll clobber you.
Oh, yeah, look at me, I'm scared.
Lay off, you stinking bitch!
Oh, do yourself a favour, Lawson. Make it quick.
No!
Oh, I'm sorry, Patty, but I can't let those mongrels hang me now, can I? Where's Patty?
Probably in her dorm.
No, just look there.
That poor kid probably want to be by herself for a bit. Maybe she's still in the loo.
What are you grinning at?
Nothing. Oh, leave me alone, will you?
I asked you a question.
Oh, what is this? Do I have to go around South Face like the rest of you no-hopers?
Don't you call me names, you smart alecky trollop.
Where's Nola?
How would I know?
Is she after Patty?
She might be.
Damn. Oh, I'll come with you. She said you were going to the loo. I'll check there. You go look yourselves. You and them? Murder. Premeditated. Looks like you're stuck with me now.
She was a pushover.
I wonder if she knew she was doing me a favour.
Eck, Lawson's been killed.
What?
We need the police ambulance quickly.
The governor knows.
You better come with me.
Right.
Is this your doing?
Yeah.
You all right, Smith?
Oh, sure. Everything's just great.
All right. Come on, Mackenzie. Smith, come with us. You wait here. The police are on their way.
Come along, Smith.
Please. We're going to have a little party. Just the three of us.
Hey, Trog.
I've got some money. Look, you can take anything. Please, I won't tell anyone.
No.
I promise you. I promise.
Bobby wants right here. You're going to beg for it. Oh.
Yeah. Yes. Yes, the police, please. Oh. Yes. I want to report it. Me, Meg. No, I'm at home. Could you come over? I need to talk to someone. I've been raped.
Sorry. I feel so dirty. I keep having to have showers.
Come and sit down. Maybe you should have waited until the police got here.
Anne!
Oh, I'm sorry, I know. I probably would have done the same thing. Have you called the police? Don't worry, I'll take care of it.
No, please!
Meg, they have to know. Those men should pay for what they've done to you.
I know, but I can't. I can't just yet.
You need a doctor.
Don't you understand? I can't. Look, I know all the rules. Believe me,
I do understand. I know what's happened to you is shocking. But you and I both know the police can't do anything unless you've got the courage to report it.
Courage? So, I'm a coward. Oh, maybe I am. When I was a probation officer, I sat through a lot of rape cases. I used to feel so sorry for the girls when they were questioned about their private lives. They were the victims. Yet they came out of it feeling so cheap and dirty.
But we both know how easy it is for those girls to cry rape. The police have to be very careful.
I know. But then, some of them are set free to do it all over again. Oh, God. I feel as though I'm losing touch with reality. I don't even feel like me anymore.
But you are, Meg. Nothing can change that.
Are you sure? But I can't tell the police. Not yet. I can't.
What's going on? I could have helped you, Luke. Oh!
Very bad mistake, Wilder.
Speak to you.
Tie her up and gag her.
Anyone want to stop this?
Nah.
Huh? Any screw lover want to save their mate? Hey? Well, come on. Speak up. There's room on the table for two. Isn't there?
Cut it out, Lou. If you're going to do it, do it!
Oh, I'll do it all right. But we've got to be fair. And I just remembered something. We didn't give her a trial, did we? Hands up for not guilty. And guilty? You tell him I'll be there in a minute. God, it's chucky here. Little listening manners.
No, Lou. Not with a stick. Look, I know she deserves a beating for breaking the strike, but not with a stick.
I'll touch her with it. Now bugger off.
I've got to get word to the old ranch. You do it.
No.
Donnelly, Ronnie and Kennedy, you come with me.
Get her into the kitchen.
Now you listen, Kelly. You've broken every rule in the book. You've hijacked members of my staff, and I won't stand for that. You quit now, and I'll...
Go to hell, Screw!
You keep this up, and I'll kill him. I'll bloody kill him.
If Moran is here to listen to your conditions, Kelly, why don't you tell him what they are?
TV reporters. I want him here in 1 hour. They're going to hear about you, Moran.
No time limit on this, ladies. So you can take all day if you like. Just have fun, if you know what I mean.
What now?
Untie their hands and get out. Go on, get out! Out! Ow! Oh. Come on, come on!
Let me go, you overgrown dog!
Come on! Go.
You silly girls. I told you this would happen one day, didn't I?
You stupid bitch. She's getting us to do her dirty work for her.
Just you and me.
Yeah, you and me. Together we can take the lot of them.
Yeah.
But we're not going to. Lose it dies, or you're both dead. Now fight!
Fight!
Fight! Fight!
Fight!
Fight! Fight! Fight! Watch, then shut up, otherwise I'll take you with them.
Oh. Oh.
Start saying your prayers, Ferguson. Because it's going to be a lot hotter where you're going than that dryer we stuck you in.
So it was you.
Oh, yeah, that's right. Real good of you shouldering the blame for us like that, you know?
Nice.
And now I'm returning the favour. You can watch Ferguson die.
Get away from her or I'll blow your head off.
Try it, Norman.
Don't be a fool, Kelly. You're in enough trouble as it is.
Drop it, Lou. They've got us.
I got Ferguson. And I'll stake the stinking bitch with me if you don't get rid of the hardware. Drop it! Now! Look here.
Hello?
You too, Morris.
Now look here, Kelly.
Shut up and put it down!
Party is over.
Excuse me.
Yes, sir.
I was asked to deliver a parcel to Mr. Jim Fletcher. I understand he's still at work, but my instructions were to see the parcel delivered to his room.
Well, Mr. Fletcher is in, sir. Look, he gave strict instructions not to be disturbed.
Oh.
Well, look, I'll take the parcel and see that Mr. Fletcher gets it at the earliest possible moment. All right.
Thanks.
Any message?
No. He knows all about it.
Now, you behave yourselves, please, you two.
Yes, madam.
I would like to see Mr. Fletcher, please.
I'm afraid Mr. Fletcher gave strict instructions not to be disturbed.
Is he alone?
Well, as far as I know, madam.
Well, then I want to see him.
Well, he
said... I don't care. I've driven my children a long way to see their father, and we want to see him.
Well, I'll try, madam, but he was very definite.
Oh, I'm sure he'll understand.
Oh, your wife and children are here to see you, Mr. Fletcher. Oh, yes, right. He said you can go on up.
Oh, thanks. Come on, kids.
Oh, madam, there's a parcel here for Mr. Fletcher, if you wouldn't mind.
Can I carry it, Mum?
Oh, all right, but don't drop it.
Good.
bit.
Mr. Fletcher, I'm sorry. We did everything we could, but...
Looks like it's just you and me, lover.
Oh, look, go away, Frank. You're rude, ignorant, and rude.
Yeah, I'm getting better every day.
Mom! Mom! No, you made me...
Come on, honey, let's go to lunch.
She's eating with me, aren't
you? Get your hands off, you bastard.
Well, if it ain't dough-faced Desmond.
Well, if it isn't little fairy floss.
Hi, Mr. Burke. Oh,
Mr. Burke. Now, that's cute.
Yes, well, bye.
Hey, where are you going? I was just about to take a smoke out. Wouldn't you like to keep me company?
I really don't think so. Now, if you don't mind.
Love those eyes.
Look. Don't let me go out. I'll hit you.
Oh, come on. Come on, I'll have you.
Stop it.
Come on, shove your muscles.
Don't. Check
your knees.
And I'm not sorry I did that. You deserved it. You're absolutely disgusting.
Bitch. Shove you. Think you're too good for me, do you? Just have to take you down a peg or two, won't we?
Oh my gosh. That's it. Get a chair quick. Did this to you. Pixie? It's me, love. It's Judy.
I want to bash up Pixie.
I think there's more to it than that, Marlene. Go and get a screw.
Oh. Oh. Oh, my God. There's only one person that would do this sort of thing to her, and that's Burke.
Well, that's right. Blame Frank. He's the only mongrel in the joint.
He was the only mongrel laying it on her at lunchtime.
So what? Murphy laid it on me, remember, and he's got the run of the joint now.
Shut up and stop arguing.
Oh, so Murphy's been up to his old tricks again.
I don't think it was him.
Yeah? Take a walk, Desmond. I want to talk to you.
For God's sake, she needs help!
She's in no danger now, Bryant. I'll see that she gets help, okay?
She needs a doctor.
Yes, and I'll see that she gets one after we nail the culprit.
Oh, come on. We know who it is.
You want to get rid of Murphy, right? Now we've got the evidence.
How?
Just get her to her cell and I'll fix it.
Oh, no, you can't use Pixie for something,
Desmond,
like that.
Desmond! The damage has been done. Now, it's not going to make any difference to Mason. No. Better this than finding her at the bottom of a stairwell like the rest of Murphy's victims. Well, she's not hurt anymore. No. See that she's taken care of properly after we fix Murphy. Time to lay a finger on anyone else.
Well, what's happening? Is an ambulance coming?
Marlene, help Judy get Pixie to a cell, will you? What? She needs to see Sister Hall now.
Judy, I love her as much as you do. Just do as I say.
Why? Just tell me why.
Don't make it any harder. Do it.
But look at her. She needs to see a doctor.
She's not in any pain. We're going to set Murphy up for it, but I promise what? We'll get Burke as well.
What? Oh, yeah.
Hang a man before you try him. I bet Murphy's the bastard.
Shut up! Just shut
please
up!
Please, get her to a cell quickly.
Oh, my God.
No, Jude. Got to make it look as convincing as possible.
Oh, God, you sicken me. I thought you'd changed, Myra. But oh, no, you are still the same heartless bitch that used to beat up on kids before Reb took over. And now you're going to use Pixie for your own good,
aren't you? Jude!
That's it, isn't it? Look at me, I'm the top dog. I get everything done, but I don't care who I have to step on to do it. That's what you're all about.
Jude, please. Look, I know how you feel about it, and I'm sorry if what I'm doing is hurting you.
Hurting me? I don't give a stuff about me hurting. It's only her I care about. Why aren't you out there getting that bastard
we will
to her? Oh, yeah, when? We're wasting time now trying to set up Murphy, and she's lying there suffering.
The only way we're wasting time is if the freak doesn't follow through. And you're wrong about Pixie. Oh, for God's sake, Jude, I am not a monster, but look at her. She's cut off. She's in her own little world. She can't feel a thing.
Oh, God. Why? She never hurt anybody in her whole life. Oh, let Frankie do this?
Yeah, we think so.
I see him in shower room. He had a big scratch on his face. He looked very frightened.
Stinking bastard. And frightened when I'm finished with him.
Hope you're not wasting my time, Ferguson.
Look, they're making alcohol. I could smell it. Now, do you want to catch them or not?
Don't use that tone with me. Which cell was it?
A Carter's.
Hey, where's the rabbit?
Cleaning up the library.
Hell, what happened to her?
No time to explain, love. You better get out of here.
Well, I reckon you lot ought to, too. I just saw the freak of Murphy headed this way.
Okay, both of you, out you go.
God, she looks bad.
Don't touch her!
It's all right. We look after her.
Please, will the two of you get out of here?
Here we go.
Righto, back against the wall, everybody. Caught you this time. Move it, Bryant. Come on, Mason. What's going on here? What's wrong with Mason?
You should know, Mr. Murphy. You did a damn good job on her when you raped her.
No, you don't, you bitch!
Get it off!
Go
on, do it! Brian, get the sister for these two. Hurry!
Bitch! You won't get away with this!
Mrs. Reynolds, how about Pixie?
She's getting the best possible treatment, Judy.
What sort of treatment? How is she?
Well, we don't really know. In fact, we won't know for some time. She's been transferred to a psychiatric hospital. Oh.
Is there anything we can do?
Her doctors think it'd be better if she didn't have any contact with anyone from the prison at the moment.
It's not fair. Damn this place to hell!
Hey, Frank.
Why did you do it?
I enjoy it. Would have made your hair curl to see the look on her face. Unreal.
There's only an old bloke in the hardware shop. I think I'm gonna throw up.
You do and I'll wring your neck. I've changed my plans once for you already, Doreen. I'm not gonna do it again. Now just sit down and don't think about it.
Don't think about it? I must be out of my mind. Come on, Frankie.
I'm staying here. Think about something else.
Like what?
what sort of farm we're going to get.
Who cares?
Doreen.
I'm scared, Frankie.
I'm not going to let you down, Doreen. Let my little brother down. That's not going to happen again.
Wasn't your fault he got killed, Frankie.
He's a good kid. Wasn't even there when he died.
Yeah. And if I'd told you the truth about what was in that telegram, you would have been there in time.
Not your fault. I couldn't read. My own stupid fault. But I'm going to get that farm, even if he's not here to see it.
Still got me, Frankie.
Yeah.
You're the best friend I ever had.
We're going to make it, Doreen.
Yeah.
All you got to do is keep watch outside, okay?
What are we going to do?
Don't panic. Come on. Nice and easy, Doreen.
He's following us, Frankie.
Get ready. Run! Here, Doreen. Run.
I'm not leaving you, Frankie.
You still got a chance.
I'm not leaving.
I've had it, Doreen. You can still make it. Let it get out of here.
I'll see you, Frankie.
Now get the hell out of here.
Bloody bastards!
Why'd you turn yourself in?
I owe a friend.
What friend?
Frankie.
What are you doing in my house? Get out of here!
If I were you, I'd make us a bit more welcome. Because we're going to have a little chat. Just the three of us. And your little dog. We invited ourselves into your lovely home because we wanted to deliver a message from Lionel Fellows. The message is simple. Keep away from the drug trade at Wentworth.
Pretend it isn't happening.
I don't know what you're talking about. Stop!
Because we wouldn't want to see a nice, respectable lady like you mixed up with drugs. What do you think, Bill? Does she look the type to be mixed up with drugs?
No, but you can't always tell.
I'll bet you've never even tried them. Have you?
Of course not.
See? What did I tell you? Well, we're going to give you a crash course. Now, calm down. Go with the flow. The first thing you've got to learn about drugs is they're a lot like sex. You enjoy it more if you're relaxed. Open wide. Swallow. Show me. Girl. Yeah. Is it your first trip? We'll just hang around to say bon voyage. You want to come and watch, boy? Having a nice time?
I accuse you of getting rid of Beast Smith.
No.
No. You had me batched. How do you plead?
No.
Forced me to make drug. Guilty? Or not guilty?
No, no, no. No, 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 no.
You sent me up for a bashing. Guilty?
I tried to take control of the racket, it's all worth it.
Oh, not guilty.
We'll soon be ready for you.
Looks like a fun trip.
Dead.
Colleen Bell. Oh, you put him through to me.
I was wondering if I might speak with the governor.
No, I'm sorry. The governor isn't here at the moment. But I'm the deputy. Can I help you?
Yes, I'm ringing about one of your officers, Miss Ferguson.
Yes.
Well, I'm a neighbour of hers and, well, I'm worried about her.
Well, what's happened?
The missus and I have been hearing some strange noises coming from her place and we were wondering if she was all right.
Have you tried the door?
It's just the last time I went over there, I didn't exactly get a friendly welcome.
Yes, all right. Thanks for the information. We'll take it from here.
Thanks very much.
Oh, could I have your name, please?
Bye.
All set?
No worries. Now we sit back and wait for the fireworks to begin.